Hello students, we are learning about lesson 6 life processes and today we will be learning about the structure of heart and this is video 9 of the chapter. See page number 106, here our pump the heart. So the question is explain the structure of human heart and this is the diagram you need to draw. Let us see the structure. First of all, now actually we have to draw this diagram. But for the explanation purpose, I have drawn an easier one so that you can understand it. First of all, what is the shape of the human heart? It is conical shape. Shape of the human heart is conical. And where it is located? It is located between the two lungs, slightly on the left hand side. Then, what is the size of the human heart? Size of the human heart is of our fist. This is our fist, like a fist the size is. The human heart is divided into four chambers. 1, 2, 3, 4. On the left side, the upper two chambers are called atrium. Right atrium, left atrium. The lower two chambers are called ventricles. Right ventricle, left ventricle. Now these chambers, these four parts are divided by muscular wall. This is called septa. This is one vertical septa, this is one horizontal septa. Then, between the right atrium and right ventricle, there is a valve called tricuspid valve, which allows only one-way flow of the blood from the atrium towards the ventricle. And between the left atrium and left ventricle, there is a bicuspid valve, which allows the flow of the blood from the left atrium towards the ventricle only. That is, backflow is not possible. Now about the thickness of the wall, the atrium and ventricle. The walls of the atrium are thinner and walls of the ventricles are thicker. And here also the atrium is thinner and ventricles are thicker. So how we write it while writing? As I have explained you the same thing you have to write about the shape, this conical, about the size, this of a closed fist, location between the two lungs. Then the heart has four chambers, upper two chambers are called atrium, one on the left, one on the right. The lower two chambers are known as ventricles, of this one is the left ventricle, other is the right ventricle. Walls of the atria are thin and walls of the ventricles are thick. All the four chambers are separated from each other by partitions called septa. There is a tricuspid valve present between the right atrium and right ventricle and bicuspid valve between the left atrium and left ventricle. This is about the structure of the human heart. Now let us see the next topic. Next topic is oxygen enters the blood in the lungs. As we know that why the oxygen, that is why the blood enters the heart, why it is pumped into? Because the oxygen and the carbon dioxide has to be separated inside the heart. So how it gets separated, that is how oxygen enters the blood in the lungs, or exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide in the lungs takes place. How it takes place, this we have to see. Question is asked in the form of explain double circulation of blood in the heart, or explain the pathway of the circulation of blood in the heart. Pathway. Now for the pathway, see, this is the structure of the heart. Here upper is the right atrium, the right ventricle. Here left atrium and left ventricle. If it is so, first of all, inside all the organs of the body, this is suppose the organs, this is one of the organ inside which the capillaries are there. Capillaries, that is one of the artery, it comes to the organ and supplies the oxygen to the cells. Inside the cells the respiration takes place and the product of the respiration is energy, carbon dioxide and water. So when the carbon dioxide is produced, then oxygen is brought by the artery, by artery to the organ. Then it branches into arterioles. They are called arterioles. Arterioles gives each cell, suppose 5-6 cells are there, whatever cells. So they enters the cell and gives the oxygen. And then from the cell, after respiration, they collects the carbon dioxide. And carbon dioxide containing branches of the capillaries are called venules. They are called venules. All the venules combine together and they form the vein. Then all the veins from all the, this is one of the organs. Similarly, different organs are there. From all the organs, each veins comes out containing blood, containing carbon dioxide. So all the veins join together and form vena cava from the body, from the vena cava. So where the heart is located, then below the heart, suppose our legs part, stomach part, from there, the inferior vena cava comes, and from the above the lungs, that is the eyes, nose, then brain, the blood comes to the superior vena cava. So vena cava is the big vein which carries the blood containing carbon dioxide from all the organs. Now this deoxygenated blood having carbon dioxide first of all goes to the right atrium. Now when the right atrium is filled, the blood enters the right ventricle. It pushes the tricuspid valve and enters the right ventricle. When the right ventricle, the blood is fully filled, then the ventricle, the lower part of the ventricle contracts, and blood from the ventricle enters the pulmonary artery. We know artery carries the blood from the organs, that is from the heart to the organs. So from the right ventricle, the deoxygenated blood is pushed into the pulmonary artery. The artery carries it to the lungs. This is lungs. Now inside the lungs, the artery enters and it branches into arterioles, and this arteriole supplies blood to all the cells of the lungs. So all the cells of the lungs, that is the air sacs, alveoli of the lungs, receives the carbon dioxide, and from the alveoli the blood absorbs the oxygen, and now it comes out as venules. Then this, all the venules join to form one vein, that is called pulmonary vein. Pulmonary vein comes out of the lungs. It contains oxygen now. Now the blood becomes oxygenated. It enters the lungs as deoxygenated. Then when it comes out as pulmonary vein, it is oxygenated blood. Oxygenated blood first of all comes to the left atrium. From the left atrium, it enters the left ventricle. And when the left ventricle is fully filled with the blood, then with great force, the blood is pushed into the aorta. This is how it is coming from the atrium to the ventricle. Then it is pushed in the upward side. The lungs is in the upward side. So from there to aorta. Aorta is the main artery which carries the oxygenated blood from the heart to all the organs. So this aorta now has several branches, each entering one organ to supply the oxygen. And inside the organ, as we have seen, that oxygen and carbon dioxide is absorbed and released. And then again the carbon dioxide goes for separation in the heart. This is the way that right side of the heart, right side contains carbon dioxide containing blood and the left side contains the oxygen containing blood. Right side is impure blood, deoxygenated blood, and left side is oxygenated blood. This is how the oxygen and carbon dioxide get separated in the heart, and this is the diagram you need to draw with the answer. So see the question. Now how you write the answer while you writing? I have explained you that first it enters the right atrium, then right ventricle, from there right ventricle to lungs, from the lungs again to left atrium, from left atrium to left ventricle, from there aorta and then organ. That means first it goes to the right side, then to the lungs, from the lungs to the left side. But while you explain, you have to explain simultaneously. That means first of all, if you write that blood is entering the right atrium from the vena cava, then you have to write simultaneously at the same time the oxygenated blood enters the left atrium. Then in the second, you write from right atrium it goes to right ventricle. At the same time, the blood goes from left atrium to left ventricle. Then from right ventricle it goes to the lungs. At the same time, from the left ventricle it goes to the aorta, so that blood gets distributed in the all the organs of the body. The simultaneous writing should be there. See the answer how it is. Explain double circulation. Why double circulation? Because once the blood enters the right side of the heart, from right side it goes to the lungs, and from the lungs again enters the left side of the heart. So this is the way, as I explained you, the answer has been written. The PDF of the answer I have sent you. And draw the diagram, that is diagram on page 106, figure 6.11. This is the diagram you need to draw with this double circulation of the blood. That's all for today's lecture. We'll be meeting in the next video.